Riley, it looks like it was a battle out there.
Oh, for sure. I mean, battles between the O and D line are always pretty physical. Always pretty fun to be part of, to be honest.
What did you expect, just generally, from Oregon State defensively, with knowing you were starting Luke and for the first time?
I felt like they were going to bring a little bit of pressure to start the game, which they did here and there. But I felt like we handled it well. Their D line plays really hard all the time, so we knew we had to be on our game, and I felt like we played pretty well.
What's different about having Luke back there? How does that change your game?
To be honest, not a whole lot. I mean, as an O-lineman, we don't really see who's back there. We're just kind of doing our job, kind of just blocking for the guy behind us. I mean, there's some plays that Connor can make that Luke can't, but there's some plays that Luke can make that Connor can't. So.
Some of those plays are Luke taking off running. I mean, what's that like?
He seems to be a lot more mobile. So he gets us out of a lot of trouble sometimes. So that's nice.
Does it seem like he's fully confident in calling new plays, checking into other stuff, or is that something he kind of has to develop?
Oh, Luke's a very confident person. He has almost to a fault where he'll try to check a run whenever he can, which Connor kind of struggled with that. But Luke can check any play. He knows the offense really well. He's worked really hard, studies his film more than anyone that I know, and just knows the offense really well.
A lot of guys, after a big play or when the camera was on, they'd be showing the CH12 wristband. Yeah. I mean, was it a pretty emotional game in that regard?
I believe so. After last week, we said, you know what, we got to go win these last three games for Con, because it's just sad how his career ended. So I felt like these last three games are more to honor him.
Was the week any different, Riley? Just in terms of, you know, you got a new quarterback, you got a different guy to be back for the last couple of years.
Not particularly. We just got after it in practice this week. Went over all assignments. Just got work done, and you know, we played well today.
Surprise you at all that you referred to them, to Oregon State, here and there, blitzing, bringing pressure. Did it surprise you that you didn't see more of them?
Not a ton. I felt like we picked it up early, and typically if that happens, then they won't bring as much because they need to cover receivers. So,
rather, we're up high, and so except when they show it on TV, we don't catch as much. But I understand a number of guys were wearing CH12 like wraps or written on their skin. Was it? What all were you guys doing?
Personally, it was kind of it wasn't really a team organized thing. It was just if you wanted to write it on you, you could write it on you. It wasn't something that we discussed, right?
So did some guys put it on their skin, some on their uniforms?
Yeah, I mean, I think some wrote on like their tape or something. Some took like a pen and wrote on like their arm or something. And you know, it's just good to demonstrate that he's still with us, even though he's still back in Pullman.
Riley, it's been a while since it probably hasn't been a somber post-game locker room. Can you just talk about getting that win?
Oh yeah, well, winning's always great, and losing, frankly, is not fun. So yeah, just winning's great, and I don't know much else to say about that.
But does it kind of take a toll when it's just loss after loss after loss for over a month?
You feel like a little down after all the games, but you know, we try to just play the next play, and treat the next game like it's a one game season. So try to win one game a week.
You guys good with Riley?
Thank you.
Thanks, Riley.
Thanks, Riley.